Good evening. Our gathering song is number 325, Like a Shepherd, number 325. Please rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Thank you.
A reading from the book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am, living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go, tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. To you, I lift my soul. gently leading the poor and the humble.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith, to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God. Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. He was only two when his parents separated. His mother, Sissy, then moved her four children into Cooney Homes, part of Houston public housing. Standing 6 feet by adolescence, sports appeared as the young man's path to prosperity. Playing powered forward, he co-captained his high school basketball team. And in football, where he played tight end, his team won the 1992 Texas State Championship. The first of his siblings to go to college, he received a football scholarship from South Florida Community College and went on to play basketball at Texas A&M. Miss Sissy, as he called her, had good reason to be proud of the young man, whom his family and friends called the gentle giant. He considered his mother the center of his world. Her name was tattooed on his torso. He was recently unemployed at the time of his death, having lost his job as a bouncer for a bar and grill. It had been shuttered due to COVID-19 restrictions. Passing a counterfeit $20 bill brought him into contact with four Minneapolis policemen and led to his death by asphyxiation. Officer Derek Chauvin's knee was on his neck for 8 minutes, long, much longer than department regulations permitted. 16 times, George Floyd gasped that he could not breathe. He also called out, Mama, and Mama, I'm through. Miss Sissy had died 2 years earlier, but anyone who's read close accounts of battles know that young men often die calling upon their mothers. Truth be told, they're calling upon God. As their worlds close in upon them, they cry out the name of the presence that first opened those worlds to them. The smile, the embrace, the voice. They learn to call Mama. It's not sacramental theology to say that mothers act in the person of God. It's basic anthropology. Each Advent, the church cries out for the final coming of Christ. And every year, she surrenders those calls to ponder the Christ who came at Christmas. Perhaps because she realizes that her own work in receiving him is not yet complete. And so every fourth Sunday of Advent, we ponder the woman who brought forth the Savior. Mary bore the Christ child, nursed him, with her flesh. But like other mothers, she continued to be the dwelling place of her son. Why? Because she was not only his shelter and support, she was the source of what would become his world. Mothers are. Yes, at first, good Saint Joseph was there protecting them both. He was all that a father and a spouse should be. But the very law of our humanity demands that we emerge from others, not only physically, but psychologically as well. Whatever the expiration date on your gender theories, man emerges from woman. She's the dwelling who makes him possible, who shelters and sups him into the world. What we call masculinity emerges both in contrast and in continuity with male and female figures. Yet the basic humanity of each of us comes forth from woman. In the ancient world, to name someone was to reveal their essence, their very identity. In Luke's gospel, it's Mary who names her son Yeshua, Hebrew, for salvation. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. The Christ and his mother are the initiative of God, not man. We do not build a dwelling which God then deigns to enter. Go, tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? When God determines to dwell with us, the genesis of this new creation lies deep in the humanity of the Virgin Mother, the sealed garden, the place from which the Christ could come forth to claim humanity, having never surrendered it. Lo, over ancient forms departing, newer rites of grace prevail. The temple of stone was gone. He dwelt in the temple of her flesh, in the temple of her being. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. Remember that the scriptures are terse, stylized testimonies of faith. They contain great truths about the nature of the church and the meaning of discipleship. The Gospels also address each of us in the depths of our own person. If we pray over them, they speak directly to each of us, telling us who we were meant to be. The abbot, Blessed Isaac of Stella, wrote, Christ dwelt for 9 months in the tabernacle of Mary's womb. He dwells until the end of the ages in the tabernacle of the church. He will dwell forever in the knowledge and love of each faithful soul. What does it mean to bear a son? What did it mean for Mary? What does it mean for us? I can't breathe. Mama, I can't breathe. Mama, I'm through. From the cross, Christ calls out to his mother. He asks the church to shelter her and for her to cradle the church. She becomes the exemplar of the church, the new Ark of the Covenant, the new temple in Jerusalem, God's dwelling among us. But beneath all of this is the misty and fertile ground of truth, that a very human Christ dies calling out to his mother, calling out to us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with his Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Having answered the call of Christ, we raise up the prayers of the church and the world.
For the church, that we may learn the meaning of discipleship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead nations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering, especially those who are alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, especially Dan Mason and Dr. Charlie Joslin, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, you chose that your Son would come forth and dwell in the tabernacle we call the Blessed Virgin Mary. Through the grace of your Spirit, help us to share that same Christ with the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Our presentation song is number 317, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, number 317.
bread to offer, which earth is given, and in the hands of neighbor will become for us
that
the bread.
Mourns in lowly exile here, until
the
Son of God
appear.
Rejoice, rejoice,
blessed are you, Lord God of all creation,
shall come to you, O Israel.
It will become for us a spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you.
Come, O wisdom from
on high,
and cleanse
me from all my sins.
Who orders all things mightily, to
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him, with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed.
You therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for us you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when, about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, fear death, give life to the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Prince of Peace, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Oh, grant us your peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 847, Song of the Body of Christ, number 847.
Dead.
to feed the hungry at our door. We come to share our story. We come to break the bread. We come to know our rising from the dead. Bread of life and cup of promise, in this meal
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lotto St. Joe winner this weekend is Dan Daniel. There are blank forms in the back of the church. Sundays in Advent from 5 to 6, there's exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, benediction, with the opportunity for confession. This Wednesday evening, we'll have extra confessions beginning at 6 and going for as long as needed. Hopefully a second confessor, I'm not sure yet. And graduated at the top of her class from the academy, and it's her first time serving. Very good job, Ayla. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Amen. Our going forth song is number 327, When the King Shall Come Again, number 327.
Shall come again.
Such as these.